Black Thunder. If I could take you to the Old South, the best and the worst of it, the glory of it, of course, the whole Gone with the Wind thing, beautiful people, stunning ballroom gowns, the white mansions, all of that. But the whole price, of course, for all of that was the misery of people who were captured, tortured, disenfranchised. Black people, and for me, there was not just this as a backdrop, but taking it right up to the present day through the freedom marches of Martin Luther King. I visited the home of Martin Luther King, where he was born, actual photographs of the place, and I think the bed that he was actually born in and what have you. And there was a black team running the place, and the guy was giving me a private tour of this. And it was extraordinary. You know, it's extraordinarily emotional. If you think what we achieve, you know, with all our privileges of being born in a certain time, in a certain place, and being white and all that, and gifted and all that stuff. And yet you think, well, on the other end, on the other scale of human emotion, I wanted this track to convey this idea of the long overdue slave rebellion. And there was another thing, when I was in West Virginia, visiting the James River. Now that's one of the strongholds to fall to the Union forces. And I couldn't help noticing that there was a slave girl who was quoted as saying, "And we saw the Lincoln coming," I think she said, "in the distance." The Lincoln. He was spoken about like Christ. You know, Abe Lincoln, this one guy who, for them, he was Christ. And it was, you know, this idea of trying to convey, what if you had a blues song that hits a gospel chorus? And I urge you to hear this in surround, if you can. If you know someone who's got the surround version of it, if you haven't got a Blu-ray player and all the rest, check it out, because it is that thing about being surrounded. It's like a musical ambush. But, you know, it was something that just had to happen. And it had to happen in music for me as well. So not only did I do that, also, you know, some people were saying, "Oh, you're going to get your harmonica out again, Steve." I said, "Well, I don't know about, you know, with progressive music," but I did get the harp out for this. The harp, the harmonica, the poor man's trumpet. Got all that out, and I played it towards the end, where you feel that it's all happening, and it's all on the loose, and it's all on the run. It's there. I'm particularly proud of this track.